one of you, honey bunny.
Everybody be cool, this is a robbery!
Any of you fucking pricks move! And I'll execute every motherfucking last one of you!
Hey, mama said the way you move gonna make you sweat, gonna make you groove. Stay.
Coming right at you, babe.
Coming right at you, babe. 1665 FM. Cool, that is not. I don't say Spreaker FM on that there, do I? Spreaker Radio.
Yeah.
Which it is. It's not Spreaker FM.
No. We're not on the FM fucking channel.
No, we're not.
No.
We're not on any fucking channel.
No.
We're on our channel.
We're on this channel.
That's right. Well, we can say what we like and do what we like. We're not bogged down to
rules
like poor old Danny Baker was.
No. No.
Was he on this morning?
He was, yeah.
Did you hear him?
No, I didn't hear it. I can't get him at medium wave in my van.
Really? How stupid that Radio 5 Live is not on FM.
Why?
Well, it's ridiculous.
It's talk, though, isn't it?
So?
Well, that's talk. Medium wave is for talk, isn't it, really?
No, it's the quality, though. It's not every other thing. It's not digital.
Yeah, but they haven't got no space, have they?
Oh, no.
The FM thing. Oh. That's why they done digital, wasn't it, I think?
Hello? Yeah. Sorry about that. That was a message. Russ, today we have to talk about this. I woke up to the news.
Your cock had fallen off?
No, that was just yesterday. That's old news.
That's old news, mate.
Woke up to the news that Leonard is a Leonard.
Leonard's a Len. Lenny's a Lenny.
Leonard Rossiter, one of my comedy heroes. Well, a lot of people's comedy heroes. A comic legend. Now, 44 years ago,
yeah,
he allegedly watched an 18-year-old fella getting raped by three geezers. And he looked like he liked it, apparently.
He was having a wank.
Yeah, is that what he said?
Yeah.
Basically, Leonard was having a wank. first of all, it's 44 years ago.
Yeah.
So this man is now obviously, you know, 63 or something like that.
Yeah.
Why isn't he not naming the three geezers that raped him?
Well, he don't know their names, does he?
Mm.
He only knew Leonard. He only knew Leonard.
So Leonard was tipped off, apparently.
He'd seen Leonard and Oliver.
Well, not yet.
No, not yet, you're right.
But it was a year to go till he was in Oliver. Very good at Oliver, he was, too.
Hello, 68, Oliver, wasn't it?
68, was it? Are you sure?
Yeah.
Yes.
So it won 69. It won the...
Oh, okay. So maybe he's in the middle of production. Maybe he was actually in character.
Mm.
So he's just, you know, while I'm in character,
I'll have a wank. Because that's what my character would do.
That's what Mr. whatever his name was would have done.
I happen to know, you know, the personal mind of Dickens when he wrote Oliver Twist.
Yeah.
And, yeah, you know, the Undertaker wanked over people getting raped by three geezers.
Well, Research.
He was doing research.
Of course he was.
No different to what Pete Townsend's defence was.
Absolutely. Don't guess what the Pete Townsend thing is. He got away with that and absolutely untarnished, really.
Yeah.
Untarnished. But he did actually...
Well, I think he could obviously prove he was doing research.
Do you reckon?
Well, obviously, otherwise they would have prosecuted him, wouldn't they?
Research? Well, I see some of them.
He got abused as a child.
Oh, did he?
Pete Townsend, yeah.
Oh, he did?
Yeah. And he was writing his autobiography at the time.
And he needed to see some little kid getting fucked up to...
I presume so.
To...
bring it all back.
Bring it all back to him.
Bringing it all back home. As Bob Dylan once put in an album.
Oh, that's a good album title.
Yeah.
Just
that Leonard Russell story, the headline was Reggie Perrin abused me. And then you read the story and Reggie Perrin done no such thing as abused him.
We just watched
him being abused. But I don't believe it.
No.
I don't believe it for a minute. I think you know, the journalists at The Sun have just thought, well, it's an all right story, he got abused at the BBC. But you've got to have a little twist on it. Where's the angle coming from here? The angle, it's got to be somebody's watching.
What was you working on at the time? Yeah. Oh, so-and-so with Leonard Rossiter there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Ah.
Could it possibly have been that Leonard was sitting there watching?
Well, yeah.
Well, I suppose he could have.
44 years ago, my mind's a bit fucking blank.
I suppose he could have. Yeah, well, he was. From now on, he was. You know, as I say, I think the papers now... It's just carte blanche, anybody in the 60s and the 70s who's not really alive. They can pick them.
It shouldn't be allowed, really, should it, Russ?
No, I don't think so. It's like, it's like a nonce lottery. It is a nonce lottery. They just put some names in the hat, pick one out and think, right, Leonard Rosser, he'll do, he's dead.
It's just not fair to his family and stuff like that. It's, you know, it's just not fair.
Without any proof.
I can't get it. I don't... How are they allowed to do it, Russ? They can't get sued by Leonard because he's dead. Not only is he dead, he's been dead for nearly 30 years. You know, I mean, that's just ridiculous. I mean, the next thing they're going to say is fucking William Shakespeare was a nonce.
Oh, he's a big nonce.
Exactly. And what the fuck?
As you like it, as you like it, up the arse.
Right.
That's what he meant.
That's right.
I mean, you know, they're all going to come out next. I mean, I'm still maintaining my favourite, Noel Edmonds. I'm still hamming up for that. You know, you can't tell me, mate. He had a programme called Swap Shop with all kids surrounding him. I know what he was doing, mate. He was swapping fucking spunk with the kids, probably. That was his swap shop.
Yeah. Swap spunk.
Yeah. Multicoloured swap spunk.
Oh, dear, oh, dear. Yeah, it's just, as you said, Russ, the story is just... It's just going to go and go and go and just get more and more twisted. More and more twisted. You know, it's not even about fucking Jimmy Savile anymore. That's the thing. He's well gone now. Now it's Gary Glitter and fucking... Freddie Starr, and now Leonard Rossiter, and next it'll be fucking Marty Feldman.
Yeah.
He fucked up with his nose.
He fucked so hard, that's why his eyes were all out of shape.
Yeah. He had a big Jewish nose, and...
My favourite is Raymond Baxter from Tomorrow's World.
Yes, a bit of Raymond
He
Baxter.
Looked a nonce then. My dad used to say to me, Don't watch that. That geezer's noncing you as you're watching it.
Who else was a candidate? Oh, I'll tell you who looked a bit suspect. Oh, I say Huey Green. Got to come out as a fucking nonce. No wonder he loved birds, didn't he? Fucked a lot of birds, Huey.
Nothing that would have come out by now, wouldn't it, Huey? Everything else about him's come out.
Yeah. Poor old Huey.
Mummy.
What's his name? Who was it? The phone jacker. When Huey was on his last legs. It's a terrible prank on him. Do you remember that?
Could be phone jacker.
I think it was Victor Lewis Smith.
Probably Victor Lewis Smith.
It was Victor.
What did he do?
He phoned up Huey Green. And Huey Green was on his last legs. He was stammering. He said, is that Huey Green? Yes. Well, actually, I'm putting together a... This is so-and-so from the BBC. We're putting together